Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted that you are with us here this morning. And if you're visiting with us here today, we trust that you like what you hear. We want to start with prayer. We want to continue to pray for our president. We want to continue to pray for our community. And we want to continue to pray for God's people everywhere, and specifically Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. Perhaps you have a special unspoken request right now. This is a perfect time to let that request be known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. We thank you for the power of your Spirit that is so available and so in our midst. God, I pray that you will continue to keep your hand on our president in these times, that you build a hedge of protection around him. I pray for our community that you will open up doors of utterance, that we can share this great truth with people. And Father, I pray for your people everywhere, regardless of what continent they're upon. Build a hedge of protection around your church. I pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church that you'll open up the windows of heaven and pour out fresh power and a renewing in the Holy Ghost and protection and healing and virtue upon this church. God, we ask this in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God. Well, I was just remarking to Sister Natasha that sometimes I feel absolute direction. And sometimes I just kind of go on what I feel for these devotionals. And today is something that is kind of a mixture between the two, but I feel very passionate about this and I feel like it's extremely important. It's found in 1 John 5. 1 John 5. And we're going to start reading in verse number 18. 1 John 5. Verse number 18, we know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, and that wicked one toucheth him not. I'm going to read that again. We know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, and that wicked one toucheth him not. And we know that we are of God, and the whole world lieth in wickedness. I want to talk to us for a few moments about the cosmic struggle. The cosmic struggle. You know, all of us are caught up with the ramifications, and in comparison to what I'm going to talk about here today, the minuscule distractions of everyday life. We have the immediacy of this coronavirus, the lockdown, all of the stipulations and ramifications that go with that. There is fear, there's confusion, there's even pandemonium in some sectors of our nation and in our world as a result of this. If we are not careful, we can allow these types of things to eclipse a far greater struggle and a far greater purpose. I'm referring to a cosmic struggle that began before the creation and formation of the worlds, before the worlds began. There is a God and there are angels. And at some point, the Word of God describes in Ezekiel 28, most notably, that sin was found in one of these angels. His name is Lucifer. He is a fallen angel. And he is in operation in the earth today. We find him first introduced in Genesis chapter number 3. And then he is also a dragon in the book of Revelation. A snake in Genesis chapter number 3 after the curse. And then a dragon in the book of Revelation. There's a cosmic struggle that is taking place that is far beyond the pandemic, far beyond the ramifications and all of the situation that exists in our culture and in our world. And I know just for myself, all of the inconveniences that seemingly have been thrust upon us because we've been able to go here, we've been able to go there, we've been able to do this, we've been able to have church. And now, because of this pandemic, there are certain situations placed upon us. Let us not forget that there still is a God that is in control of the universe. And there is a fallen angel that is now a devil or an adversary. And he has minions of demons and devils that work with him in tandem to destroy the human race. Let us not forget that Jesus Christ came as the Savior of the world, but he was more than just the Savior of the world. He was a prototype, an example of a person that can live above sin, defeat the powers of darkness, and live above this world, but only with the power of the Father, the Holy Ghost, are we able to do this. And so, while all of us are being greatly inconvenienced, and all of us are having certain situations, and I want to just tell you very frankly, I've even felt myself that from moments here and a moment there, I can almost feel the dark grip of depression try to get into my mind and try to drape over my spirit. But I realize that this is the spirit that is working in this world. The book of Isaiah called it gross darkness covered the people. Let us not forget, there is a divine struggle going on. And when we talk about struggle, we are not talking about a struggle for power. This is not a struggle for power. Because the devil, being a created fallen angel, is no match for the omnipotence and the omniscience of an almighty God. So what is this cosmic struggle all about if it's not a struggle for power? It's a struggle for influence. The devil gained the right to influence the human race at the fall of Adam and Eve. You know the story well. Through subtlety and trickery, Satan was able to misrepresent God's true purpose for Adam and Eve, and they were beguiled. He's still working in the world today, misrepresenting, putting false ideas in people's brains about God's intentions and God's designs. And so make no mistake about it, there is a cosmic struggle that's taking place, but it's not a struggle for power, and it's not a struggle for supremacy, and it's not a struggle of who's going to sit on the throne of eternity. Those things are forever settled. But it's a struggle of influence. And God has limited himself in his foreknowledge, his omniscience, his omnisapience. He has willingly limited himself to operate with certain limitations in the affairs of men. But there's a battle going on. There's a war going on. There's a struggle going on. Don't allow yourself to become distracted or despondent or depressed because you're not able to have certain conveniences at this time. There are some nations in the world that have never even thousands and thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of people have never even slept on a bed. Don't become depressed because we have certain limitations. Recognize I'm part of a greater struggle, one that's in the heavenlies, but has now come down to the earth. And I am a good soldier, and I am a child of God. And I know who my Redeemer is. He delivered me from sin. He has furnished me with power. He has furnished me with a revelation, the revelation and the understanding of a cosmic struggle. For you to operate and to walk in that and to live in that will already give you an advantage that no education, no understanding, no dialogue, no program, no pill, nothing. Nothing can rake back the covering and give us the revelation and the understanding that the entirety of the human race lieth in wickedness as the result of a cosmic struggle. But you and I have escaped through the power of a Redeemer. God manifest himself in the flesh to reveal a cosmic struggle that is now being settled on the earth. Thank God for the blood. Thank God for the waters of cleansing and baptism. And thank God for the Holy Ghost, which gives me power to live above sin, to live above darkness, to live above the world, to live above the flesh, and to walk as one that understands the whole world lieth in wickedness, but we know the way out. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here today. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow.